One of my favorite things to do with shortcuts is set up per app automations. For instance, every time I open the Photos app, my orientation lock unlocks. This way I can rotate and see things in landscape. Whenever I open a social media app like Instagram that may play video, the volume on my device turns all the way down so I don't have to be disruptive. If you want to share photos, using the Pika View app automatically launches guided access. And we'll set up other useful automations for apps like Halide, the Blackmagic camera app, and more. So if you're like me, I like orientation lock locked all the time. I never want my iPhone flipping around without me expecting it. But whenever I open the Photos app, I want to be able to rotate my device so I can watch things in landscape. Well, you can do this automatically with a Shortcuts automation. If I open the Shortcuts app and go over to the Automations tab, this is where you can set up lots of different triggers. And I plan to do future videos on more automations, so if you have any questions, drop them in the comments. But the trigger for these automations I'm going to use is called App. If I choose App down here, now I can say whenever an app is opened or is closed. Then I can choose a specific app. I have a lot of apps, so I'm just gonna search for Photos and then hit Done. Now this trigger is for the Photos app. Whenever that app is open, and we can set up a different automation for is closed, it's going to run. Now I want it to run immediately. I don't want to see any kind of confirmation. I just want it to happen behind the scenes, and I don't need a notification when this runs. Now I'll hit Next, and we're going to add a single action. Let's tap here in the search box and search for orientation, and you should see this action, set orientation lock. If I tap that, you'll now have the option to toggle orientation lock, or if I tap toggle, I can choose turn and then choose on or off. You can do toggle, but I find if for some reason you turned it off manually and then you open the Photos app, it might go to a state that you're not expecting. So I like to set it that whenever the Photos app is opened, orientation lock is turned off. That means it will no longer be locked, and when I open the Photos app, I can rotate my device. If I hit done, now this automation is added to my phone. If I scroll down here, you'll see that automation, when Photos is opened, set orientation lock. So now you'll see in the control center, my orientation lock is locked. But if I open the Photos app, I can look again and you'll see orientation lock is off. Now I've set up a secondary automation. When the Photos app is closed, I've set orientation lock to on. This way, whenever I exit the Photos app and swipe up to go home, I know that orientation lock is going to be turned on automatically. So you can see rotation lock on, open Photos, rotation lock off, swipe home, and the lock is on again. This is also a great automation to use for apps like Halide or the Blackmagic camera app. If you go to the built-in camera app, it will allow you to change the orientation on your device, even if you had orientation locked. But apps like Halide don't have that option. I can open Halide and rotate my device, but it still thinks I'm in portrait mode. You can tell by the orientation of the One X. So let's set up another automation for when Halide is opened. I'll go to the Shortcuts app, the Automations tab, scroll down, I'll choose App, I'll search for Halide and select it there. I'll say when Halide is opened, run immediately, don't notify me, go to Next. Now I can search for orientation lock, but it's actually already being suggested to me here. And rather than toggle, I want to hard code it to turn orientation lock off. Now I can set up a second one for when Halide is closed, but let's test it. So orientation lock is on. Let me open the Halide app and I can turn my phone and you'll see now I'm in landscape. Everything is in the proper orientation, because orientation lock was automatically turned off. Automating the orientation lock option is great for any app that shows photos or videos that you might want to rotate horizontal. Now let's create an automation so whenever we open Instagram, or it could be TikTok, the volume on the device goes to zero. This way if I play a video or accidentally go to the Reels tab, no audio is going to play and distract people around us. I'll open the Shortcuts app. Let's hit the plus button again. We're gonna go down to App, and this time let's search for Instagram. So we'll say when Instagram is opened, run immediately, don't notify me. I'm actually gonna do a new blank automation. For some reason, it's not pulling up the media volume in that search box. And there we have media set volume. We can just add this one action. And if I tap media, you'll see ringtone and media are both options. We want it to affect the media volume, which is like social media apps. And we wanna set the volume all the way to zero. I'll hit done. And now we have when Instagram is open, set the volume to zero. I also have this automation for TikTok, which again can be very loud if you're not expecting it. So now I can be sure either of those apps will mute themselves, and right there you see it on the side, whenever they opened. Now I can add another automation for when the app is closed to raise the media volume, but honestly, I'm good manually raising it when I'm ready after I leave the app. I don't need to automate it raising the volume again. Another helpful automation is to enable a focus mode whenever you open the camera app or an app where you're capturing photos or videos. So again, we're using the same trigger this entire video. I'm gonna go to an app, and I'm gonna choose the camera app. I want this to run immediately. no notification. I'm going to start with a new blank automation because not all the actions come up in the search bar on that first screen. I'm going to search for a focus, and here under scripting, I'm going to choose set focus. Now I actually have a focus mode called shooting. So I'm going to say turn shooting, and we want it to turn on until. Now these automations are not going to work for us. It's not really going to trigger once we close the camera app. So we'll probably need to create another automation for when camera is closed to turn off this focus mode. But now what this does is if I go to my focus modes, I'll show you the shooting focus. It's very simple. Absolutely no one and no apps can contact me whatsoever. It doesn't change my home screen, watch face, or anything like that. I have it set to complete do not disturb once this mode is enabled. This is also helpful for apps like DJI where you might be flying drones. You want to make sure your screen isn't taken over completely by a FaceTime call. Setting this kind of focus mode ensures you will be distraction-free and your screen is yours for the entire time the app is open. And now you'll see when I open the camera app, this will actually set the focus mode automatically. You can see the focus mode very discreetly turned on there at the top. Of course, I can swipe to control center, see that the shooting focus mode is on, and now I make sure I won't be distracted when I'm filming. Now, I think it's also helpful, especially for this kind of automation, to create one for when you close the camera app. So once again, we're going to go to the app trigger. When an app is closed, make sure to uncheck is open. We're going to run immediately. Let's search for the camera app again. We're going to choose set focus for this automation as well. Turn the same focus mode, our shooting focus mode, off. This way we'll go back into default, or you can go back into another focus mode if you'd like. Now when I open the camera app, you'll see my focus mode for shooting is going to be enabled right here at the top. I'm not going to get any notifications or distractions. And when I swipe to go home, you'll see that that focus mode is then disabled and I'm back to normal. All right, one more app automation and a bonus one. A great app if you want to share photos, but make sure someone doesn't overswipe and see more photos than you intend, is the PikaView app. With the PikaView app, you can choose only specific photos to be viewable every time it's opened. But if you handed someone your phone right now, they could still swipe up to go home or adjust the settings. So a great thing to do is to enable guided access. Guided access is a feature where you can lock the phone, remove the ability to adjust the settings or go home. And when started, you set a passcode to lock and unlock guided access. And now someone can't go home, they can't see more pictures than you intended, including videos, and your phone is safe. Then to disable guided access, you triple click the side button again, ending guided access, now I can go home. So it would be great if this will actually enable automatically every time I open the PikaView app. So we can create the same kind of app is open, PikaView is the app chosen, and for the action, we're actually gonna start guided access as soon as that app is opened. I'll hit done, and now when I open the PikaView app, you'll see guided access automatically popped into place. I didn't have to do anything, no triple click, and now no one can swipe home or adjust the settings. To get out of it, I still need to triple click and then put in the passcode, but it's a great way to automatically enable guided access whenever you open PikaView. All right, and one more bonus automation. This is for Apple Watch. One more trigger you can do when you create a new automation is when a workout is started. You'll see here Apple Watch workout. You can choose when it starts, when it ends, of course, run immediately. And you can actually change your watch face based on the workout or just whenever you start any workout. So you can choose a specific workout type and we'll say when this workout starts, we're gonna run this immediately, no notification. Let's start with a new blank automation. And then you can choose set watch face for when this automation runs. Now it's not super convenient to choose a watch face from here, but these are the watch faces you have programmed in the watch app in the order they appear in the watch app. So you could go over, see my faces and kind of see which face you're actually choosing. And I actually have this modular face set up specifically for when I work out. I can see heart rate and activity big on the watch face. I don't want to show and run and I'll hit done. As you can see, I'm on the modular ultra watch face. If I go and start a workout, let's do a cool down. Now that I started a workout, if I go back home, it'll go to my specific workout watch face with my activity, quick access to things like heart rate and cellular if I'm outside. And when I'm ready to end the workout, whenever a workout ends, it'll go back to my modular ultra watch face so I'm back to normal. So hopefully those are some helpful specific app automations. If you'd like to hear more about shortcuts or other automations, leave a comment below this video. And I have an entire shortcuts 101 video to start you from the very beginning with shortcuts. Really teaching you the basics, you could check that video out up here. And if you want to follow me on various social media like Threads, X, Mastodon, and Instagram, this is my handle. Also, those links are down in the description. And if you're into automations, especially home automations, I have my favorite 10 home automations right here and have a tour of my smart home coming up very soon. So subscribe to the channel, like this video. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next time.